Diazepam is a long-acting benzodiazepine with rapid onset commonly used to treat panic disorders, severe anxiety, alcohol withdrawal, and seizures. In this video, let's find found. What is diazepam? What is diazepam used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking diazepam? How does diazepam work? How to use diazepam? What is diazepam? Diazepam, first marketed as Valium, is a medicine of the benzodiazepine family that acts as an anxiolytic. It is commonly used to treat a range of conditions, including anxiety, seizures, alcohol withdrawal syndrome, muscle spasms, insomnia, and restless leg syndrome. Diazepam was patented in 1959 by Hoffman La Roche. It has been one of the most frequently prescribed medications in the world since its launch in 1963. In the United States, it was the best-selling medication between 1968 and 1982, selling more than 2 billion tablets in 1978 alone. In 2020, it was the 128th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 4 million prescriptions. What is diazepam used for? In general, diazepam is useful in the symptomatic management of mild to moderate degrees of anxiety in conditions dominated by tension, excitation, agitation, fear, or aggressiveness such as may occur in psychoneurosis, anxiety reactions due to stress conditions, anxiety states with somatic expression. Moreover, in acute alcohol withdrawal, diazepam may be useful in the symptomatic relief of acute agitation, tremor, and impending acute delirium tremens. Furthermore, diazepam is a useful adjunct for the relief of skeletal muscle spasm due to reflex spasm to local pathologies, such as inflammation of the muscle and joints or secondary to trauma, spasticity caused by upper motor neuron disorders, such as cerebral palsy and paraplegia, athetosis, and the rare stiff man syndrome. A diazepam nasal spray is indicated in patients 6 years and older to treat stereotypic episodes of frequent seizure activity that are different than the patient's usual seizure pattern. Contraindication. Use of diazepam should be avoided, when possible, in individuals with ataxia, severe hypoventilation, acute narrow-angle glaucoma, severe hepatic deficiencies, hepatitis and liver cirrhosis decrease elimination by a factor of 2. Severe renal deficiencies, for example, patients on dialysis. Liver disorders. Severe sleep apnea. Severe depression, particularly when accompanied by suicidal tendencies. Psychosis. Pregnancy or breastfeeding. Side effects. Drowsiness. Dizziness. Tiredness. Muscle weakness. Headache. Dry mouth. Nausea. Constipation. Pharmacodynamic. Diazepam is a benzodiazepine that exerts anxiolytic, sedative, muscle relaxant, anticonvulsant, and amnestic effects. Most of these effects are thought to result from facilitation of the action of gamma-aminobutyric acid, GABA, an inhibitory neurotransmitter in the central nervous system. Mechanism of action. Diazepam is a benzodiazepine tranquilizer with anticonvulsant, sedative, muscle relaxant, and amnesic properties. Benzodiazepines, such as diazepam, bind to receptors in various regions of the brain and spinal cord. This binding increases the inhibitory effects of gamma-aminobutyric acid, GABA. GABA's functions include CNS involvement in sleep induction. Also involved in the control of hypnosis, memory, anxiety, epilepsy, and neuronal excitability. Half-life. Diazepam has a biphasic half-life with an initial rapid distribution phase followed by a prolonged terminal elimination phase of 1 or 2 days. Its action is further prolonged by the even longer half-life of 2 to 5 days of its principal active metabolite, dimethyldiazepam, nordiazepam, the relative proportion of which increases in the body on long-term administration. Dose. Anxiety. Indicated for management of anxiety disorders or for short-term relief of the symptoms of anxiety. 2 to 10 milligrams, POQ6-12 HR, or 2 to 5 mg 4/IM Q3-4HR if necessary. Third, anxiety disorders, 5 to 10 mg 4/IM Q3-4HR for severe anxiety disorders. Alcohol withdrawal. Aid in symptomatic relief of acute agitation, tremor, impending or acute delirium tremens, hallucinations. 10 mg PO6-8HR during first 24 hours, reduced to 5 mg PO Q6-8HR, PRN or 10 mg 4/IM, initially may give additional doses of 5 to 10 mg 4 Q6-8HR as needed. Endoscopic procedures. Adjunct use. If apprehension, anxiety, or acute stress reactions present prior to endoscopic procedures. Less than or equal to 10 mg adequate, may give up to 20 mg 4, particularly when concomitant narcotics omitted. If 4 cannot be used, 5 to 10 mg IM approximately minute prior to procedure. Titrate 4 dosage to desired sedative response, such as slurring of speech, with slow administration immediately prior to procedure. Dosage of narcotics should be reduced by at least a third and in some cases may be omitted. Preoperative sedation. If atropine, scopolamine or other premedications desired, they must be administered in separate syringes. 10 mg IM preferred before surgery. Sedation in the ICU. 5 to 10 mg for 1 to 2 hours before surgery. 0.03 to 0.1 mg/IG Q30 minute to 6 hours muscle spasm. May be used adjunctively for relief of skeletal muscle spasm due to reflex spasm to local pathology, e.g., inflammation of the muscles or joints, secondary to trauma, spasm associated with local pathology, cerebral palsy, athetosis, stiff syndrome, or tetanus. 2 to 10 mg, PO, Q6-8HR, PRN, or 5 to 10 mg, 4/IM initially, then 5 to 10 mg Q3-3HR, if necessary, administer larger doses for tetanus, seizure disorder. Indicated for acute treatment of intermittent, stereotypic episodes of frequent seizure activity, i.e., seizure clusters, acute repetitive seizures, distinct from a patient's usual seizure pattern. Used adjunctively in convulsive disorders, although it has not proved useful as the sole therapy. 2 to 10 mg, PO6-12HR intranasal spray. 0.2 mg per kilogram intranasally as single dose. Adolescent or adult weight-based dosing. 14 to 27 kilograms, 5 mg, 1 5 mg device, 1 spray in 1 nostril. 28 kilograms, 10 mg, 1 10 mg device, 1 spray in 1 nostril. 51 to 75 kilograms, 15 mg, 2 7.5 mg devices, 1 spray in each nostril. Greater than or equal to 76 kilograms, 20 mg, 2 10 mg devices, 1 spray in each nostril. Second dose and maximum dose. Second dose, when required, may be administered after at least 4 hours after initial dose. If the second dose is administered, use a new blister pack of diazepam intranasal. Maximum dosage, not to exceed 2 doses to treat a single episode. Treatment frequency, do not use for more than 1 episode Q5 days and no more than 5 episodes/month. Safety advice. Advice and warnings for the use of diazepam during pregnancy. FDA pregnancy category D, positive evidence of risk. That's all the information about diazepam we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.